The solubility product, KS, defines the equilibrium between a slightly soluble salt and its constituent ions in solution. The reactant is always a solid whose activity is always 1, so the denominator is always 1. For the products, the nature of the salt is important. The empirical formula for a salt may contain 1, 2, 3, or more cations, and the same can be said of the anions. This information must be incorporated within the solubility product by raising the concentrations to the appropriate powers. When doing calculations with ice tables, we use the solubility product. However, to express the solubility of a salt, we can also define it in terms of the molar solubility, expressed in moles per liter, or the solubility, expressed in grams per liter. When doing calculations, we always assume that the solution is saturated, and we can go from a solubility expressed in grams per liter to moles per liter, and finally work our way to a solubility product. Alternatively, we can go in the opposite direction, from a solubility product to a molar solubility, and finally to a solubility. Two distinct situations may present themselves. One is solubility in pure water, and the other is solubility in a solution where one of the constituent ions is already present. The latter creates the common ion effect. Taking lead iodide as an example, consider its solubility in pure water, calculated on the left, and its solubility in a 0.5 molar aqueous solution of sodium iodide. Either way, the solubility product is 8.5 times 10 to the negative 9 at 25 degrees Celsius. For both calculations, construct the initial line in the ice table. In pure water, both ion concentrations are 0. In the 0.5 molar solution, the initial concentration of Pb2+ is also 0, but the initial iodide concentration is 0.5 molar given the presence of the sodium iodide salt. The change line in the ice table is always identical in both. Be sure to take into account that the salt yields 2 iodide ions. Finally, the equilibrium line is the sum of the first two. In the 0.5 molar sodium iodide solution, the value of 2x is negligible compared to the initial value of the 0.5 molar. With that done, we use the solubility product to find the value of x in each case. We then take the molar solubility x and convert it to a solubility by multiplying it by the molar mass of lead iodide. As we can see, the solubility of the salt is greatest in pure water. The common ion suppresses the solubility, as would be expected from Le Chatelier's principle. The final type of equilibrium in aqueous solution that we will see is the formation of complex ions, where a metal cation center is complexed by a finite, predefined number of neutral molecules or anions. Unlike everything we have seen to date, they feature huge equilibrium constants rather than small ones. We must therefore alter our strategy. Using the hexaamine cobalt 3 complex ion as an example, with a formation constant of 4.5 times 10 to the 33, let us follow the procedure for calculating equilibrium concentrations if we place 0.05 moles of cobalt in 1 liter of a 0.75 molar solution of ammonia. For these calculations, given the huge equilibrium constant, assume the reaction goes completely to the products until all of the limiting reagent is gone. In practice, it is always the metal cation. Be sure to take into account the stoichiometry of the balanced chemical equation. Finally, assume that the back reaction occurs to a very small extent. The only concentration that is appreciably altered is that of the limiting reagent that was assumed to have gone to zero. All the other concentrations are unaffected. Simply use the equilibrium constant to calculate the concentration of the metal cation.